Welcome to Retro Toy Review. My mission, take you back to your youth by locating, opening, and reviewing retro toys. G.I. Joe, one of the greatest and most successful toy lines of all time. Created by Hasbro back in 1964, the Joes were 12-inch figures. Then they were rebranded in 1982 as the 3¾-inch figures you still see today. In 1985, Hasbro came up with what may be one of the best cross-promotional marketing ideas in all of toy history. They went out and signed professional wrestler and All-American icon, Sergeant Slaughter. Hasbro not only used Sergeant Slaughter as a spokesman for the toy line, but also incorporated him into the animated series as a character himself, and even made him an action figure. And why was this such a brilliant move on Hasbro's part? Well, to understand that, you have to understand a little bit about Sergeant Slaughter himself. You see, back when he was young, Sergeant Slaughter, whose real name is Robert Remus, spent 6 years serving in the U.S. Marine Corps in Vietnam. Then, when the war was over, Remus got into professional wrestling, incorporating his Marine Corps background into his wrestling persona, known as Sergeant Slaughter. Sergeant Slaughter became the ultimate wrestling good guy, an all-around American hero in the eyes of wrestling fans. Sergeant Slaughter's popularity rose in the ranks, particularly with his boot camp matches, which were all-around slugfest between him and his ultimate nemesis, heel and all-around bad guy, the Iron Sheik. These matches skyrocketed Slaughter's popularity, making him a fan favorite. By the mid-80s, Sergeant Slaughter was one of the most popular wrestlers of all time, second only to Hulk Hogan.
Yo, Joe!
It was at this point that Hasbro signed him up to be a member of the Joe team. Hasbro had Slaughter play a huge role in both the comic and the cartoon, having Remus himself voice his own character in the animated series and G.I. Joe the movie.
I've been expecting you. My job is to whip you into shape, and I'm talking whip. There's only two ways out of my command. On your feet like a man, or in a ditty bag. An itty bitty ditty bag. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Sergeant Slaughter's character on G.I. Joe became a huge hit with kids, and everyone was excited to get their hands on a Sergeant Slaughter action figure. But Hasbro was smart. They didn't just release Sergeant Slaughter as a regular figure. They made him a mail-away. And finally, when the mail-away offer was over, they still didn't release him as a regular figure, but packaged him with a vehicle. And here it is, Sergeant Slaughter and the Triple T, also known as the Tag Team Terminator. The only way you could get a Sergeant Slaughter action figure was by buying this vehicle. On the boxes of most G.I. Joe vehicles, the name of the vehicle was listed in big letters. Then it had in smaller type, a pilot or some sort of figure that came with it. This box outright says Sergeant Slaughter in big bold letters, with the Triple T. They treated it like you were buying Sergeant Slaughter and getting a bonus vehicle with him. Anyway, let's open this box and check things out. First, you see the plastic bubble holding the Sergeant Slaughter figure. There's a bag containing the wheels, weapons, and stickers. The top half of the main body. A couple of treads. And the lower half of the main body. And the instructions and things like that. So here are all the parts. Time to build this thing ourselves. First, we'll put on the stickers. Then it's time to snap the guns onto the main body. Take the wheels and snap them to the lower part of the main body. G.I. Joe was always cool in that the toy line required you to put things together. It was kind of like building a model. Though a lot of kids were impatient and slapped things together and broke them while doing it. Now it's time to snap the two main body halves together. And then finally, snap on the treads. The Triple T tank is a very nice little vehicle. Though it doesn't have a lot of action features, beyond the guns and missiles on the side. There's the engine that you can look at. and this hook on the back, I guess for towing other vehicles. The details are nice though, and it does look pretty cool. Though the best part about this vehicle is the fact that it comes with a figure. And not just any figure, Sergeant Slaughter, who is the ultimate G.I. Joe. He comes with this little accessory, a baton. I guess the sergeant is such a tough guy, he doesn't need any weapons. Slaughter is a very well done action figure, and he looks really cool sitting in his tank. As a kid, Sergeant Slaughter was my favorite G.I. Joe action figure. I'd always have him out on patrol in his cool tank. He'd spot some nefarious Cobra action going on in the distance, roll up, get out, and kick the crap out of any Cobra bad guy in his way. Which begs the question, why did Hasbro place so much emphasis on Sergeant Slaughter's drill sergeant role, when really he was like Rambo, a one-man army out on the front lines fighting Cobra mano a mano? He didn't need to train recruits when he could win the war all on his own.
Attention! You pathetic pukes! You call yourselves Joes! How are we supposed to defend America if you can't even take a leisurely 5-hour jog? Get a shave, hippie! Suck in that gut, big boy! What are you laughing at, tough guy? Scatter, Joes! That's it. I've had it with these motherfucking snakes on my motherfucking beach!
Cobra!
Will Cobra ever learn? So what kind of score am I going to give this thing? Well, if I were grading this on the vehicle alone, it wouldn't get a good score, because really, the vehicle doesn't have a lot of play features. But because of the simple fact it comes with the hands-down best G.I. Joe action figure in the entire line, I'm going to give it an 8. Sergeant Slaughter, wrestler, spokesperson, action figure, and animated character, all rolled into one. And what's the Sarge up to these days? Well, he goes around touring with comic and toy conventions. But more importantly, the Sarge donates his time to children's hospitals and charities. He truly is a real American hero. I'll be back.